Scientists are hoping that history does not repeat itself. Conditions in South Puna are strikingly similar to an eruption in the same area more than 60 years ago. Manolo Morales has details. Manolo?
Film footage obtained from Lyman Museum in Hilo documents the eruption in South Puna in 1955. Swarms of small earthquakes also happened before lava broke through the surface.
The fissures opened up in about the same area where currently there is some concern because of the ground cracking and the shallow earthquakes.
The eruption lasted nearly 3 months and destroyed roads and property along the lava's path.
Certainly, if it were to happen today in the same place, there are many more homes and structures in danger.
UH geology professor Scott Rowland tells me to this day it's still not clear what causes lava to erupt. Magma underground can move along the rift zone, but why it stops and rises to the surface is still a mystery.
Once it starts happening, you say, aha, the magma stopped moving and it's starting to erupt. But why it happened there and not someplace else, I think, is something we can't really answer.
Which is why emergency officials are asking residents in the lower Puna area to stay alert for any updates. Rowland says the earthquakes are caused by magma pushing the ground underneath. Scientists at the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory are gathering as much information as possible, recording the earthquakes to determine how far down they are.
By knowing how deep those earthquakes are, much more precisely, you get a much better sense for how deep the magma is.
Manolo, how far below the surface are these recent earthquakes?
Well, Professor Rowland says they're about a few hundred feet, which he says are actually pretty shallow. Now, so shallow, in fact, that the residents report that they were able to hear the earthquakes, a cracking sound from underground. Joe.
Thank you, Manolo.